When we roll with the PoE NVR, usually we need to pull the Cat 5 or Cat 6 Ethernet cable from the cameras to the rear of the PoE NVR. Then we can connect the cable to the PoE NVR port. The PoE NVR is supply both power and data to these cameras. It's so convenient, right? There's no need for power source at the edge. However, in some situation, you may feel very difficult to pull the cable from one or two cameras to this PoE NVR. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can connect the camera to the local network by using the external PoE switch instead of this PoE NVR. Eventually, you still can set up a system, but you don't need to pull the cable from the camera to this PoE NVR directly. If you want to learn more about the IP camera and networking, please click the subscription button and hit the little bell, so you will get notified whenever I release a new video. Before we move to the demonstration world, I would like to say this workaround is the vendor specific. There's no guarantee your PoE NVR will work with this setup. The reason is there are two kinds of PoE NVR design in the market. With the first design, it used two different subnets for the uplink port and the PoE port. In this design, the PoE NVR will not detect the camera from the local network. The second design is the uplink port and the PoE port use the same subnet setting. So in this design, you can connect the camera from your local network instead of the rear port of the PoE NVR. At the end of this video, I will show you how to verify whether your PoE NVR satisfies with this requirement or not. Now let's move to the demonstration world and set up the system. This is the 4-port PoE NVR. This is the uplink port. The uplink port is connecting the router so you get the internet accessing. Usually, we need to put the cable from the camera to one of these PoE ports so the PoE NVR can supply both power and data to the camera. In our scenario, it's very difficult to put the cable from the camera to one of these PoE port directory. So I use the PoE switch. This is the PoE switch. We can place this switch at the basement or another building. And we also need to connect this switch to the router. This is the uplink port. We're using the Ethernet cable to connect the switch to a router, so both switch and the PoE NVR will stay within the same local network. The next thing I need to do is use this short patch code. Actually, I can use the longer cable. The maximum distance between the camera and the switch is 328 feet. Now, I use this short patch code to link one of the PoE port to the camera. So you can see the camera is getting the power. Let's just wait for a while. You see the data is transmitting to this PoE switch. And then the data will jump back to the router and to the PoE NVR. We can see the camera is live now, right? So in this setup, there's no need to put the cable from the camera directly to the PoE NVR. It's getting the data from the camera in the local network. It will be flexible, especially if the cable is already exists between the router and the second location. What you need to do is just add the new PoE switch. Remember I mentioned this workaround is vendor specific. There are no guarantee your PoE NVR will work with this setup. So how do I know my PoE NVR satisfies this requirement before I buy the PoE switch? Actually, it's quite simple. What you need to do is get your IP camera and connect the camera to the network port on the router. Remember, it's the network port on the router, not the network port on the PoE NVR, otherwise it will work. And you probably also need this power adapter because the router doesn't support PoE. So eventually, if your PoE NVR can see the camera after you connect the camera to the router, that means it satisfies this requirement. Then you can buy a new PoE switch. By using this external switch, actually you can have more feature. For example, this is the long run PoE switch. It can supply up to 1,650 feet long run between the camera and the long run PoE switch. You can reference my another video if you need to have the long run for the IP camera.